Hello guys! Today I want to talk all about my favorite bullet journaling supplies. I hope this will be helpful, especially for those of you who are newer with this whole bullet journaling thing, but I try to make this super informative just for anyone watching. I've now been bullet journaling for around 2 years, and I've definitely started to find the products that I gravitate towards and that I think are just unbeatable. So let's start with the most obvious one first, which is of course the notebook itself. My favorite at the moment is hands down the Archer & Olive A5 Dot Crit Notebook. I recently did a full-on review of these, so I won't get super specific here, but for me the best thing about these notebooks is definitely the thick, crispy white paper that doesn't let any pen bleed through or any drawing show through the other side. If, however, you're looking for something more affordable, I'd recommend the Lemome hardcover notebook, which is like half the price, and it's still a great notebook for bullet journaling. I've also heard good things about the updated Scribbles That Matter notebooks, but I haven't used them myself yet, so I can't really say anything about that. But I guess that's it about the notebooks, and now let's move on to my pen collection. Before we get started with all the fancy, colorful stuff, I just want to point out that even after 2 years, I personally still draw everything with a pencil before anything else. So obviously, a pencil and eraser are essential bullet journaling tools for me, but then when it comes to black pens, I've personally sticked with the Sakura Pigma Microns. These are pretty popular pens in the bullet journaling world. They are smooth, pretty inexpensive, they are easy to find, and they come in various sizes. So when it comes to just normal writing and most things in my bullet journal, I typically use the size 01. It's definitely my most used pen, and I've gone through so many of these during my bullet journaling journey. I have these in two different packaging, which can be a little bit confusing, but they are exactly the same pen, it just depends where you buy them. Then the two other sizes I'd say are must-haves for me are 08 and 005. The thicker 08 pen is great for drawing thicker lines, and I often use that technique to make my boxes and decorations a little bit more interesting. In the past, I also used this to make black boxes for my titles. Then the thinner 005 is great for drawing, and I often find myself using this for any illustrations I'm doing in my journal, as well as writing down numbers or letters if I want them to be really small. So yeah, these three are the main black pens I use. Then let's move on to something more colorful, and this will be the brush pen section. I think starting to collect brush pens in the beginning can be pretty overwhelming because they are not cheap and there are too many colors and brands to choose from. So I really tried to narrow down my whole collection to only show you my favorite colors that I would run out to buy if all my pens disappeared. I'll start from my Tombow dual brush pens that are really good brush pens in my opinion and also pretty popular in this community. They're not the cheapest ones, but I think the color selection and the quality of these pens is worth it. So the first colors I would personally recommend for everyone are the light gray tones, which are the Cool Gray 1 and Warm Gray 1. These are hands down my two most used brush pens. I use them in almost all of my monthly themes to complement the other colors, and they create so pretty and sophisticated look just on their own too. The only difference between these is just the undertone, and I usually choose one of these just based on the other colors I'm using. I also often use these in my illustrations because they are just so good basic colors to use anywhere. However, if you want to go one step darker, I really like my Warm Gray 2 as well, which also looks really nice just on its own. Then I'll show my four personal favorite colors, and these are the colors Sand, Asparagus, Grey Green, and True Blue. I like very natural, earthy tones, as you can see, because they are just the most versatile to use in any theme, especially if you get a lot of inspiration from the nature. The first three are also colors I use in my illustrations all the time, especially when drawing animals or plants. Sand is such a great base color for almost any animal's fur, and the two greens create very nice leaf decorations. True Blue is just a pretty color. It's not super versatile, to be honest, but I love this slight teal undertone in it. Then I picked four colors also from my other brush pens, which are from the brand Kuretake. And these are the Sick Clean Color Real Brush Pens. The brush in these is definitely different from the Tombows. It's a lot more flimsy, and honestly, they are a little bit more difficult to use if you want to create smooth lines. But sometimes the effect these create looks super pretty. It's kind of closer to the look of applying watercolors with a real watercolor brush. By the way, I totally forgot to mention that you can use both of these pens for calligraphy. I just suck at doing that, so I mainly just focus on drawing. Anyway, my favorite colors from these are Pale Dawn Gray, which is probably my most favorite brush pen colors, period. Then I have Blue Gray, just a gorgeous grayish color again. Then Haze Blue, which is a super light baby blue color. Again, perfect to mix with other colors. And then finally, Tea Rose, which is this orangey pink. I just used this color in my May theme and I just love it so much. So yeah, those were my favorite brush pens. If I would give advice for someone starting out, I would probably say that go for lighter colors first. You probably want to use your brush pens behind titles or to create some simple decorations. So light colors work so much better, and you can always layer them to get a darker tone. Dark colors stand out quite a lot from the white pages and might not be the easiest to use or to create multiple themes with. But then I have a couple random pens to show you that I also use in my bullet journal all the time. So the first one is also from the brand Kuretake, and this is their colorless brush pen blender. If you like to draw with your brush pens, I think a blender like this is so essential. It creates a much softer look on the paper, and you're able to get lighter and darker color depending on how much water you're using. I love this technique, I use it all the time, and I personally think that this one pen makes your brush pen collection so much more versatile because you can really modify the colors with this. Then let's talk about my two white pens that are great to change things up a bit and create titles over darker background. The first one I have is the Uniball Signo White Gel Pen. This is great for writing, but it does tend to skip a little bit, especially if you try to use it on top of pencil or on a rough surface like a watercolor paper, for example. Mine sometimes just stops working and it's super annoying, but it works well most of the time. The other white pen I have is super different from the first one, and it's the Uniposca White Marker. This has actual white paint in it, and I always use this if I need white in my drawings. This pen is very opaque, you can even layer it if you let the first layers dry, and it doesn't skip like the gel pen does. It doesn't always work that well on a wet surface though, so sometimes it tends to sink into my brush pens a little bit, which can be frustrating, but again, this pen works most of the time. I would say for me, this one is a little bit more reliable than my Signo gel pen, but I still think both of them serves a little bit different purpose. Another pen I use often is my Fudenosuke Soft Tip Pen. This is actually meant for calligraphy, but I never use it for that purpose. Surprise! I use this pen also for drawing and coloring bigger areas black. I'll quickly show you the difference between this and my black Tombow used with my white pens, so you'll see why I prefer to use this if I want to create backgrounds for my titles. The combination of my Furenosuke and the Zikno gel pen is the best for this job. The Uniposca marker also works well enough, especially if you do a second layer. But you can see how the pens work totally differently on top of the Tombow. I even let the background dry before going in with the white pens, but the Tombow is still so water-based that many pens tend to sink into it like this. So if you've been struggling with this problem, you're not the only one, and I hope this helps you. But okay, we've been talking about pens for 5 years, so I'll quickly go through the final products I think are must-haves for me. The first, quite boring one, is a ruler. Now you don't need to use one, not everyone does, but I personally like the look of super clean lines in my journal. Any ruler will do, and I just use this old dirty ass one in almost all of my videos. And I think this starts to be a little bit more advanced stuff, so when you're in the point where you want to take your journal to the next level, I highly recommend trying out watercolors. To be honest, I've yet to find a bullet journal that works well with watercolors. So if I want to make an actual painting, I always do it on a separate watercolor paper and then just tape or glue it to my journal. For that purpose, my favorite has been this double-sided scotch tape that has a really strong hold and keeps my paintings in place really nicely. I feel like when it comes to watercolors and watercolor paper, that's definitely a separate video itself. So I'll just list the ones I used in the description to not make this one too long. Then the final thing I sometimes use, especially with watercolors, is washi tape. And I actually don't usually use these as decorations in my journal, but I love to use them to make clean lines with my watercolors. So for example, if I want to apply watercolor really close to my boxes or something. Some tapes rip off the paper quite easily, and in my experience, washi tapes are a bit more gentle, so that's why I often use them as a border. But yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. I might do a video like this in the future, talking more about the ways to take your bullet journals to the next level. But I wanted to keep this one a little bit more beginner friendly and just mainly talk about the super essentials. Anyway, I really hope this video was helpful for you, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I'm happy to answer them. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope all of you are having an amazing day or night wherever you are, and see you in my next one. Bye bye!